to direct the discussion. If you ask, may I talk the child or you know the angry alter? Okay, I'll ask. Then you know you can start the big conversation. It's not possible the normal whole mind. It's not possible for obsessive mind. It's not possible for psychotic hallucination. But you can talk with this mind. And other things, if some patient having a lot of medication, but nothing happened, please consider the idea. Because medication no help. I'm using medication, I will say, but usually for comorbidity or some PTSD symptom, not the cure, DID. It's a real photograph. Mm-hmm. You know, some DID patient came to me and said, okay, I used all of this medication, but nothing changed. Look at the, you know, maybe you don't know the name of four of them antipsychotic, five of them is an antidepressant or anticonvulsant. All of the medication, all type of medication they used, but nothing happened. And also, this is the also real photograph. The patient, the ID patient, went to Hoja and explained as a gene. There is a gene. Genie is inside. Okay, I don't, you know, explanation, that because, you know, in Turkey, I'm saying the practice in Turkey, some hoca used to say schizophrenic patient, you know, it's like a gene issue. But now they learned. Schizophrenia, you know, psychiatrist is a not treat the schizophrenia, they say, okay, this is for the doctors. Please go to doctors. I can't make a dua, but it's the doctor. But DID patient is a very good their approach, because people don't look like a psychotic, but there is a, you know, talking voice inside, and the talking also the hoca. That means there is a gene inside, and I'm talking with the gene. And I say, okay, I'm talking the gene every day. Because all of the patient, one of the their alter, they say, I'm gene, I'm Satan. Okay, welcome to Satan. When you happened, when you, first time you came to this mind, you know, he was like 8 years old, you know, he went to Hoca or, okay.
Hoca is an alim, some people
talk. Actually, this kind of Hoca is not the normal alim. Okay. It's like we know the Jinji Hoca, Büyücü.
Okay. It's Raki.
Okay. it's not, you know, well, good people, most of them.
Amen.
Yeah. It's not, you know, normally, they say, okay, I can say some, you know, dua for you, but it's not that for treating, you know. You please go to doctor or psychologist. Most of them do that. But this is the making money, this kind of person. It's like a business. Mm-hmm. It's a big business, you know. Some people taking more money than doctors.
Oh, wow.
In one session. And also second was but description of amnesia. It's that the directly coming from the my file, having no recollection of when I was 7 to 10 years old. I was going to take one pill and the rest is history. Took 70 pills in reality. It's not the drug effect, you know. One personality started, you know, take and they control the other alter and take taken other alter or old drug. Inability to recognize friends. Having no recollection of amount of time that has passed when daydreaming. Having no recollection of 6 hours on trip to China. Waking up the unknown sights. Lapses in memory regarding the personal life story. Inability to remember moment of sexual abuse. Finding notes in an unfamiliar style of writing. You know, this is an amnesia example. Also, daydreaming is very common in the VID patient. Very, very common. Longing at oneself in mirror for hours. Losing oneself in world of imagination. They create like a Alice in the Wonderland. I will say something. They have a, you know, they, if your patient say, you know, daydreaming about you, panic the daydreaming, but it's very deep, long hours, please consider ask this DID question. Talking to oneself in the mirror. And the other important is that changing affect, speedy changes in facial, facial expression. I become an, you know, I'll say specialist. And sometimes now I'm at the session, I'm looking at their face. If sudden speedy changes, if there is a speedy changes, for example, you know, the one lady, there was a lady, she was a, you know, chemist, chemistry. Chemist. She's a small, tiny woman, you know. And one day, he look at me, you know, it change, you know, some become a, you know, alter personality. Look at me like a, you know, angry glance. I become like a, you know, how to say it, tetrarch. You know, I'm a good man, you know. I became afraid, you know, because she look like, she's eyes glance so angry. If you see any angry glance, very deep, very directly, you know, if the happen unexpected time, please consider the eye. Some of the patient coming from the anger control, anger problem, they say, I'm becoming like a, you know, green man or in, at this, you know, in the movie, you know,
Hulk.
They say there is a, some Hulk in my body. If we became control the body, I became a different man. Please consider the idea. It's not the, you know, only, you know, the storytelling. It can be real. And or, you know, patient started like a childish cries, or changes have, you know, become a very happy, you know, unexpected be. Sudden, please, this is the, you know, affect dysregulation, affect change, affect changes, please consider the idea. Because, you know, the one alter taking control of the another alter. Explanation is very simple. And another problem you know, focusing. Why is focusing is a problem? Because, you know, attention, I should say attention. Some of this, DID patient taking the attention deficit disorder diagnosis. Why? It's a very simple, you know, if you have a multiple identity, multiple alters, one control in 10 minutes, then other controls another 10 minutes, another control, takes control another 10 minutes, that means your memory changing always. And if you are trying to study, but you have a voice in your mind, how can you study? You know, the unexperienced psychiatrist giving medication for this person, is that, you know, ADHD medication. Mm. Okay, it helps, but not the, you know, if you give a medication, you know, authentically DID patient, it's a, like a miracle. It's help a lot, but it's a little bit help, like a, you know, 10% or 15%. But if you treat DID, their academic performance enormously increasing. Mm-hmm. I will show, if I have time, I have a video. This lady became, when she was a high school student, yeah, her grade wasn't good enough. Even until the, you know, treatment completed, she hasn't got any, you know, success. But after that, she became, you know, the very successful student at the school. If you treat their, if you, they might become an integrated, their academic performance is enormously increasing. Please consider, you know, it's a, there is a spectrum. If you look at the severe or the rare, simply civil, United States of America, you know. Do you know the United States of Tara? Do you know this movie? Or is, I think, one of the best, because the, you know, the one of the leading specialists worked this move for this movie. Clough, Richard Clough. He was an advisor of this film. Because of this reason, it's if you want to understand the idea, please watch this TV series, I think. United States of Tara. But it's, you know, the severe case. Most of case is mild and very mild. Okay, this is my classification. And at the number of alters, extent alter has individualized, has how level is different at each other, degree of amnesia, type of trauma, number of trauma present, and the extent DID has impact daily life. If you use six criteria, you know, now you look at the number of the alters. Very mild, two or three. But in very severe, more than 15. Actually, there are two types. One of them is a, you know, very, you know, alter number is more than 100, maybe. Is that, as we say, is a çok parçalı, or after say in the multi-splitting. But most of them case is a between 10 to 25. And you know, only if you do very smart, only that form of the inner voice. Some cases has only inner voices. Says, okay, I have an inner voices. He's talking with me. It's not the harmful me. It's very simple cases. But, you know, the mind alters of emotional state of certain ages and partial control of body. If you look at very severe, individuals alter an ability to take full body control. Degree of amnesia, daydreaming, periods of full amnesia. Look at the, you know, very severe. Type of trauma, and if the there are more trauma, that means more complicated. Tools for screening diagnosis, I think all of it coming from the United States, maybe last one from the coming to Netherlands. That's, you can find. Do you have an experience, do you have any work with the DID patient? Anyone? Okay. You can find the dissociative experience scale easily in the internet, you know. Mm-hmm. We have a, you know, translated and the, you know, in Turkish. Colin Rose, he is a very good specialist. He's, I think he's originally from Canada, now working in Texas. He is very good at this. I'm considered triple person. One of them is a Putnam, one of them is a Colin Ross, and another one is a advisor of the Richard Clough. This three persons are leading authority about the DID. Okay. How can we treat? How many minutes I have?
30 minutes.
40?
30.
30 is enough. 34, okay.
And then 15, 45 in total, 30 okay. For talk, 15 for question.
Okay, that's meaning we don't have time for video. Okay, no problem. There are three phases of treatment. Clarifying the diagnosis and alter system, working on traumatic memory, and the integration of identities. Three different phases. Original state of the mind is the dissociated state of the mind. Mind purity and integration, integrated state of mind. And the time required to treating DID is up to very mild cases, 5 session, mild maybe 10 session. I become very fast. I used to very slow. Now I am very fast. Usual people takes DID patients takes more than 2 years, 1 year. If you look at only severe cases, yes, it's true. But for the most cases, is a mild or moderate, 10 or 20 sessions is enough. I can do, my psychologist doing every day, it's 20 is all right. But if it's severe or more severe, no. If there is an sexual abuse, it's not easy. Mm-hmm. It's not easy. It takes more time. Especially the incest, if I'm correct, pronunciation. If there is an incest, it says so difficult. It's not easy. Mm-hmm. It's not easy because splitting mind very fiercely. I'm not afraid of DID patient, but I'm afraid of DID patient with incest. Because sometimes they need a hospitalization of it takes several years. It's not easy job. DID treatment is working directly with alter. Main things, please consider the alter personality directly. Not the Irving Yalom. He is a famous. He was a famous. I think is he living still? Irving Yalom is a very famous in Turkey. You don't know? He's American. Okay. He has a book. Therapy. He's telling the therapy story. In his book, he's seeing some alter personality, and saying the patient, don't consider to him, because if you consider to this another alter, it can be grown. 100% wrong. You have to work directly, alter personality. If you see any alter personality, welcome. May I see? May I talk with you? Even persecutor alter. No, there is actually no persecutor alter. You can say, if I control, I can harm you. Why? You are, you're a psychiatrist, so why not the problem? Never anybody hurt me, it's not what the problem. If you understand, actually, the alter, all alter. Coming for the coping, as a coping mechanism. Mm-hmm. If you think all alter is a different coping mechanism, nothing to be afraid, you know, mm-hmm. there is only one person in there. Mm-hmm. And the, you should know all alter, and you should know the alter system. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is very important. You should have a map, all the system, all the system. Look at the alter type. Host personality is not the real person. It's a, also is a you know, alter. Host personality means, you know, keeping the most of the time the body control. It's usually depressive. Mm. And persecutor, actually, it he was a helper, but turned to persecutor. Child, almost there. Helper, opposite sex. Look at the, you know, my books. One of the, there's a map. There's a drawing for me. The some artist. It's not a copy. Copy alters of people. I maybe, you know, copy, we invented this term. Copy alter means, you know, one day, my clients stop to come to me, DID patient. Then one day she came. I said, "Where were you?" She said, "Okay, there are also one of you in my mind, and he is cheaper than you, and he always with me. Why can he come to you?" Because she made an altered copy alter for me. There is a Medaim in her mind. When I see any copy alter, I'm directly to try the out of the mind. Because he is becoming like a behaving like me. It's dangerous. You know, if she had any affection to me, inner copy alter in their mind behaves and the patient don't differentiate. Sometimes they think, oh, doctor's doing that. It can be good or bad. Copy is very dangerous things, you know. They are copying every important people in their life. Sometimes the abuser, sometimes the helper. And they're talking with the, you know, copy alter. And then also, you know, emotional states, like some alter has a name, different name. But some alter has a, you know, only angry, sad, harsh Ayşe, or, you know, sad Ayşe, this, you know, young Ayşe. It's like a, you know, the, and sometimes there is a one executive identity, it's a boss. Always a boss alter stay, wait until the you know, the last of the therapy. And one of them became control the body, say, I said, where were you? You know, we are, you know, I was visiting you, I was monitoring to you. And she asked me, where were you? I'm managing the system last 15 years. You came only, you know, 1 year. Why asking the question? I was a boss. And you came changing the system. Did you ask me?
Interesting.
She's, you know, the boss.
The boss.
Actually, it's also a coping mechanism. The organizing other alters. Is also absorbing other alters. Also, you know, some alters becoming like a dichotomy, their life view. Like a religious atheist, or who loves one dad, or who hates another one, hates the dads. Actually, normal bad Ayşe, like the thing in my file, cannot stand injustice, gets angry easily. If people do not respect my opinions, I flip out. is wearing she's wearing black boots, boots, leather jacket, glasses. I'm asking always the author, what's your wearing? For example, jacket. He says, blue, and he says, I have a white. In imagination, every author, they own their clothing style, hair style, gender, or old, it's different old, sometimes smaller than or younger than or older than. You should take all of the it's an original photograph also. One of the author controlled the body, but he wouldn't talk. He couldn't talk. I give a pen. Please, can you write it? And we start the conversation with writing. I'm asking some question, and he is writing. It's an original photograph. And some author, have quality to contradict one another. For example, one of them is going. Or not going to work is that like a voting. Joe want to go, harsh Joe no. Sleeping or not sleeping, Joe wants to wake up early, harsh Joe wants to sleep. And this guy wants to marry it, but other alter don't want to marry it because he has had some trauma. And also is that we have this kind of paper, every different alter should see in one page, because if alter person comes to you, you should know speciality of the alter. You have to write all my DID patient file look like this. 100 pages or more than, because you have to write it. Oh, wow. If you say wrong name, then say, no, I'm not Ahmed. I'm not Mehmet, I'm Ayşe. Why are you saying it to me? You are not sleeping well today? And also, integrated, look at the different times. One of them is Angelic Amy. Integrated is different time. Hairy, integrated is a different time.
Interesting.
And sometimes alter attitudes towards persons can be changed. Look at there are six different alters. One of them sleepy. For example, sleepy alter control the body. They can sleep more than 16 hours.
Oh, wow.
If you see this kind of things, because consider the idea. It can also, sleep disorder. Okay, I know that. But sometimes, in normally, there is not this kind of things. But some days, he or she sleeping more than 16 hours. Please consider the idea as a sleepy alter. And maybe like Amy, child Amy with multiple sclerosis. This lady has a multiple sclerosis. Angry Amy. She was at some relationship with some guy, and she made some wrong things. One of them, sleepy, because I think she had love with him. Wanted to lean and Adam's shoulder and sleep. Another one wanted to slap him across the face, to make like Amy. If you find it, he did, because he's like a bodyguard. Think you are a child and you need protection. If you say, if I became a male, I were more stronger. Then they create a male alter. But problem, male alters then changes during the time. They say, okay, I'm a man, I will marry with her. And the, you know, in real lifetime, she was trying to marry, but the altar don't give her permission.
I see.
You are for me. You cannot marry another man. It looks like a psychotic. But if you ask, if you talk to this altered personality, say, okay, you are not the real man. You know, one person. I developed some of the test. We say it's a PAM test. It's very easy. You know, if your patient is a woman and has man altar, I say, okay, this is the man hands. I'm putting this pen to here. Please take the pen and put here with the male hand. Mm-hmm. And there's some patients, please, look at this, this is a lady hand. Please take with your the male hand. Like, do you understand me?
Interesting.
Then they understand, oh, I don't have a different body. Mm. Until now, they think they have a real body.
I see. Interesting.
If you show them, there is only one body, only person. It's very important, the turning point of the treatment.
Mm.
And you should look at the not only altar, or look at the altar system. Look at the mapping. It's a real photograph. I only changed the name. It's one of the mapping. It's a very multiplied person. But it's a mapping, the system. There are big system. Okay. And amazing things happening in their mind is like an artificial intelligence happening there. You know, the machine intelligence, artificial intelligence. Okay, one day robot will have an artificial intelligence and control the world. But it's happening in their mind. Because this is a Every alter is a real mind. They can think, they can speak, they can own identity. That means, times change. They have ability to learn other things and change, become a different person.
Hmm.
And they have a, system. It's for a regret for us. I don't know, understand me. Our patient have a deep, they have a enormous world in their mind, but we don't know.
Hmm.
If you study this patient, every time you became amazing. Oh, he's an ordinary man, ordinary woman, but he's got a mind like a, and he's in the Wonderland.
Hmm.
Amazing, after the as a scientific, science fiction novel or the movie, the ordinary high school students have a city in their mind.
Hmm.
Sometimes they have a different languages in their mind.
Hmm.
It's daydreaming all day. And they are establishing a new world in their mind.
Hmm.
If you don't ask, you don't know what's happening in their mind.
Hmm.
Look at this lady. She got sexual abuse, and look at the sexual abuser in copy altar inside in her mind. When she came here. Still it passed maybe 6 years, but still having abuse in their mind, because she has got an abuser copy alter, and doing it regularly, and the child alter or the disorder didn't know time passed. When you discovered her, she still thinks, you know, happening again and again, this today also. You, if you say, oh, this happened six years ago. No, it's happening now. Because I'm feeling, look at things, keeping my hand. No. Look at my office. Look at the, you know, the date. Today, look at that. I'm showing the calendar. Look at, what do you think, which time we are? I say, look at it, please. I'm, you know, giving time to time, a lot of time to orientate it to this time. It's happened at the past. Now, it's the man in your mind is not real. Your mind, you know, like a draw it. It's a biological draw, you know. It's an enormous, you know, thing. Like a, you know, how to say, if you machine, you know, we are meeting here, but president talking with another city, is identity showing, or what was names? In English?
Holographic?
Yes.
Hologram.
Hologram. Their mind producing hologram, living hologram, like a copy on the hologram belief on the real man, and the other type of side of mind believe this is the real man. You should change this. You know, it's not real. Your mind made it. Everything. When I know. Very practical guide book, because I you know, coming people, the IND patient other side of the country, it's you know, it's a community problem, health, public health concern. I'm a Muslim, you know, it's not a good person for the person, people. You know, I have a responsibility. I should learn, teach to, you know, psychologist. Most of them, my students, psychologists, because no medication, and psychiatrists haven't got enough time. Psychologist is a perfect for the treat the idea, and the other psychiatrists getting angry to me. Why are you psychologists? You don't become powerful. I said, okay. I'm a responsible man, you know, people have a, you know, problem, they are living, is, you know, they have to, you know, if you want to learn, okay, I can teach you also, but you haven't got the time, you have to write a prescription. And then what happened, you know, all of the, after the sometimes, you know, look at the first, maybe, 3 months before period, you know, and that I sent the two men from the mind, and I say, okay, sexual abuser also sent it. This is a technique also, and look at the, you know, the two girl. I built a safety house in their mind, and the girl who is carrying abused memory, I put it down to the safety houses. Still we are working. This problem, host personality is very powerful, and she don't want to accept this lady because she wants to think they have a sexual abuse, not me. But I say last session, you are looking like, you know, you are behaving like a, you know, your komşunun kızı, how to say?
Neighbor's daughter.
Neighbor's daughter. No, they are yours part. They are your story, you know. You have to accept that. Without accepting that, you know, you cannot heal. I'm saying more complicated because of language. Please consider this. There is only one body, there is only one people, but a lot of identity. This is the round table meeting technique. If you say this person, let's make a meeting, and then it used to make it square. Yeah, then I realized, oh, it's a, like a hierarchy. It should be round.
Mm.
Then make a, you know, some desk, sit on it, and they can sit, and they can start to talk with each other.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Wa alaikum
assalam. Okay. As you know, this is my book. We can translate its title as a seven qualities characterizing happily married couples. And I will present. This presentation is okay. Is conference version of marriage enhancement program. I developed it in for Turkish people. Originally, it lasts one day, and I have 50 minutes, and I will give a conference. This presentation was also coming from my research. I conducted research, interviewed 70 happily married couples. And they were married at last 10 years, and they seen themselves as happy. They described themselves happy, and also community find them. They say this is the happy couples. Why I'm doing? I'm a couple therapist also. Every day I'm seeing two or three couples, several years. And okay, I'm seeing the couples. They are usually, you know, fighting, and they are not looking not happy, or they scrum are unhappy. But I thought, oh, this is the one part of the picture. Where is the happy marriage? It should be. But nobody talked related to that, you know? And I thought, I should find them. And I made a research, I found them. And then I asked them, and I made an interview with them. I think it's very important to understand. You know, you should look at the picture. You should see all picture, you know. Okay, in one, at the spectrum, at the one hand, very happy marriages. And the other end of the spectrum is very unhappy marriages. Most of people, you know, fall in the middle one. Okay. If you look at the all of them together, I have a chance, because I'm a couple therapist. I have a file. I know everything about them. They are talking, they are describing their story to with me. If I also, you know, talk with the happy marriage, okay, that means I can look at the two different way. And I will do with you. Because, you know, if you look at the media, everyone talking about unhappy marriages. Do you remember, think about that. Do you remember anything the people talking about, you know, happy marriages? There is. But you have to go there and ask. If you don't ask, they don't say anything. They are living, you know, they are happy marriage. Why, they say? Unhappy marriage always complaining, you know? But if you ask them, then they start to talk about their story. Why is the quality of one's marriage so significant? Because our relationship, especially with our spouses, has powerful influence on our health, not only mental health, also physical health. If your marriage is good, your physical health is better. We know the mental health also. But, other hand, marriage also have a capacity to bring great pain, suffer. Two things together, you know, big happiness and big, you know, pain together. It's possible. For example, look at the Turkish, you know, your side is, the birth rate is the highest. Maybe ours is a modest. But 126,000 births happened in 2016. And if you look at 35% happened in their marriage in 5 years. Early phase, early the marriage. Okay, it brings happiness, but if your marriage is conflicting or you are getting divorced, there is a significant risk. For because you are become under stress, you know, you will probably will have a depression or anxiety symptom, or poverty will occur. You know, is a poverty is a one of the prediction is a divorce. If you divorce, your money will lose. Yeah. Also, children will affect. I'm also the ID specialist. I am listening a lot of, you know, story. If you are coming to conflicting parents, possible your mind divided is possible. It's huge consequences. Okay, we understand. It can be happy or great pain. But can we do something? It can be changed? Yes or no? Do we know the absolute formula? What's the happiness? No. If I know, I will be the richest man in the world. You know, everybody, you know, father and mother give them money. Let me say, okay, this couple will be happy or not unhappy, or divorce or not. Actually, I wrote about book about this. It's another issue, but there is no absolute formula. But if you look at the, you know, physical health, do we have an absolute formula? No. But we know if you do regular exercises, if you do, you know, good sleep, adequate amount of sleep or stress management, your physical health will improve. If we have enough information about the marriage, if you distribute to the people, we can improve the marriage. It is possible. We don't know exact formula, but we know enough knowledge. If we teach the people, marriage can be better. I think for your society, for Muslim society, I'm saying, or for Turkish, we need three things. One of them, we need some guidebooks. It should be so practical. No. Spouse have some question, and this guidebook should give an answer, very practical way. Do you have? Do we have? No. My students start to study about that. I'm trying to prepare for the Turkish. But we, you know, we will have a guide for the, as a Muslim community. And also, we need manage and hazardous program, not only conference. Because you have conference, we are only giving knowledge, information. Is that good? But it is not enough. We need a skill. How can we take a skill? Practice it. You know, in my workshop, couples come together, sitting together, and another, you know, there are 3 meters between other couples, and they talk each other, not the other peoples, because of culture. If you, you know, ask in Turkey, I don't know here, people don't want to talk their about marriage, you know, in front of the other peoples. But if you sit, you know, each other, they can talk. They can talk. Also, marital counseling, it should be rich, isn't it? There is a big problem for the Turkey, it's now. We have a perfect health system now. Insurance covering everything. It's easy, but we have a problem with that. I'm also, you know, sometimes advising to government. They are preparing to do this because it is a problem. I think it should be, you know, we can easily, if necessary, we should take a medical counseling. Okay? According to my research, happily married couples have 7 different qualities. First, number one, they have a positive outlook towards their marriage and to the one another. First one, positive outlook. Second one, they accept their differences. I will explain all of them, you know, during the presentation. Their fights do not take a destructive form. Okay, sometimes they have a quite a problem. But they not fight as a destructive form. Number 4, they do not remain close. Or maybe I should say, küsmek, very, very common things in our culture. I don't know, it's difficult to find in Turkish. In English, this küsme, what must mean küsme, is a crossing or silent treatment. Number 5 quality, they protect and maintain their sexual routines or life. Number 6, they are able to manage the challenges of shared life. Number 7, they are good friends. I interviewed the people, couples, and I look at the content analysis, then I classify. Let's start first quality. I will present some quotation from my research, also, you know, the couple files. Happily married people tend to think, I'm married to the right person. I'm happily married. I want to stay married. They say, I want to stay married. Look at what they say. For example, a wife married for 24 years say, my husband is a good, hardworking, humble, and compassionate person. Very positive outlook. And another married woman for 19 years, we are a good match and I feel peaceful with him around. He is my rock and does not hesitate to show his love. A husband married for 16 years, we have grown closer and closer over time. Very positive outlook. Look at the unhappy marriages. You know, I'm quotation from the file or so. I think I married the wrong person. I'm unhappy in this marriage. Should I get divorced? They're asking themselves. Look at what they say. I don't trust him. It feels like he doesn't want to best for me. One of us can live any minute. Another quotation. I keep finding myself thinking how things would be like if I were married to another person. I keep thinking, what if, especially after our fights. These thoughts come to my mind so much that it feels as though my is going to burst. Okay, I have 8 advice for you. It's going like this, you know, I will describe the one, number one, then, you know, from the happy marriage quotation, then the unhappy quotation, then I will recommend something, you know. First, keep remind yourself of how you and your spouse met and married. What's your story? Usually, you know, beginning is better. Think about it again and again. Because if you, it's a mind working like that. If you think your good days, it's not growing, like a network is growing. Yeah. Keep reminding yourself or your spouse positive attributes. You know, it should be, you know, you should believe in it, you know. He is a trustable person. Okay, he has some problem, but I can't trust him. He's a good father, she's a good mother, you know. You should remind yourself again and again. Because after the fight, all negative memory comes to, you know, suddenly. You should, you know, educate yourself. Okay, all of negative things comes to my mind suddenly. But, you know, my husband has this positive things. Or, you know, my wife also has this quality, you know. You should educate your mind, you should educate. Keep remembering the positive memory in your marriage. Like a watching video, you know, in your mind. Sometimes it's like exercises. Okay, stay and think. We have a good things in this time, like, you know, like a watching video in your mind. Be generous in your expression of gratitude. Express your satisfaction of the one another as frequent as possible. Remember, compliment sports skills. Touch your spouse as frequent as possible. Touch instills love and affection. Buy gifts for another in all shapes and forms. Gift increase closeness. It's not necessarily so expensive, you know, very simple things. Serve and care for your spouse just as you serve your children. It's not that, you know, become a, how to say, is a, like a köle, is mentioned. No, it's a good things to service in your wife or your husband. If you want to stay married, never give up this philosophy. You know, it should be go well. Try and again. You find another way. Think another way. Never give up. I should be go well. Okay. The second quality. That accept their differences, you know. For example, look at this curve. One age, too organized. Other age, very disorganized, you know. Look at where is it exactly you are, and where is your spouse exactly? Okay. Your place is close or distant. If you are at the one point of spectrum, And your spouse is other side of the spectrum. That means you have a little bit trouble. Okay? You have to manage it. Because, you know, a lot of, speciality, suspiciousness, jealousy, perfectionism, selfishness, you know, openness to new things, motivation, level of happiness, is it different? Mm-hmm. Okay? In my, workshop, I'm giving the couples, please sign your place and your couple place and discuss. If you are, two different points, that not means you are not a good match, not a mismatch. Okay, whoever you married, it will be, inevitable. Look at the happy marriage. Happily married husband. Our differences seem to be more. She is very hardworking. While I tend to be more lazy. However, when a problem arises, we like to communicate with one another and they find a common ground. We are able to communicate and solve problems. We have common hobbies too. Happily married wife. I'm an organized person who does not take it well when things don't go as a planned. As for him, he is much more relaxed. Dude is he's able to adapt the chase better than me. However, our life plans and philosophy are quite similar. Look at the unhappy marriage. What's their story? We are not a good match. I'm a home person, he is an outdoor person. He keeps wanting to socialize outdoors. Actually, he will not say no if I suggest to join him. But I don't want to keep socializing outdoors. When discussed this, he tells me that I'm trying to stuff him in indoors. You know, they are not managing their differences. Okay, good. There are three things you have to do. One of them, you have awareness about the differences. Okay? And you should accept. Because it's not relating to. It's coming from the childhood, some of them, it's a character, it's a personality. It's not with you. But you have to manage it. I have a five piece of advice for this. One, whoever you marry, there are bound to be differences. Having differences does not mean you guys are not meant for another. There are more than 100 traits. It's inevitable to become, the different points. It's not a big matter. But you have to be aware of it. You try, you accept and manage it. Be aware of the fact that your supposed differences have to do with temperaments and disposition and not necessarily with you. Reflect on your supposed similarities and differences and increase your awareness on these matters. Be aware of the fact that while mild differences have a potential of benefit, but excessive differences are potential of being destructive to your marriage. Upon discovering the extreme differences you guys have with one another, make a list then and plan how you will manage them. In workshop, they are choosing one of them and they're making some plan how to manage their differences. Okay. You can do it in your house. It's not difficult. Third quality, their fights do not take a destructive form. Happily married, give us this kind of story. We are quarrel, do not fight. Their quarrels are not so frequent. They require a mild severity. They require as in a resolution. Okay? Look at the example. A husband, though it is not frequent, we do about once a month. Yes, these are the form of quarrels, not the fights. We will disagree on something, quarrel about it, then it's done. We will not become cross with one another. But there will be a few hours of silence. Being cross like a 3 days or four, five days or more? No, not exactly, never happened. Usually I apologize, and they become buddies again. A wife, I have no recollection of my husband screaming at me. In fact, usually, it's I who may scream. Yet, our disagreements are usually mild quarrels, and it's a form that we are able to speak the recovery from. Look at the narrative of the, you know, unhappy marriages. They say, you can never know when our fight will be begun. But once they do, there is an immediate raising of voices. It's almost like we are having as a fist fight. And especially those blatant words of my wife, and yet the rolling of her eyes, or that flips me out. Who knows what I look like if I were to look at the mirror at this those moment. It's here both of them happening. The whole building wake up during our last fight. We both screamed terribly. We did not touch one another, but crushed each other with our words. He blamed me and I blamed him. And we both did not stop. I can't stop myself in such incidents. I want him to take things calmly, and then he doesn't. We both have a real tendency of getting angry. Sometimes, you know, couples have a fight, who has a power at the house, you know? Will my word pass or not? Look at, you know, the graph. There is a, you know, sub-scenario. Who will word pass? 101 and 01. It's like a tyranny, you know. It's a padishah, king. It's not suitable for the marriage. 9 to 10? No. 8 to 20? No, impossible. See, 70, 30? No. You know, it should be, you know, close. And some matter, one supposed have a word, and another matter is another. You know, power should be balanced in their, at the suppose. And what's your decision-making process at your house? I think it's a very important question. If anybody say, what I say must happen, or reciprocal discussion and the collective decision taking. You know, like a, you know, we say is a community, you know, should take some decision together, you know. It's like a, look like the, in the cup at the house. Another reason for fighting, difference, having a different need. Look at the graph, you know. At the one left, two spouses say, okay, we are married, but we should have enough space for each other. And I don't know so closeness. Look at the other side. It's like a marriage philosophy. We should always come together inside to inside. No, there is no without life without me. Okay, always we will trade together. No. If you are one side, your spouse is another side, it's a problem. You should find a way, you know, and you look at the others' need to pay, pay you know, the middle one. I have six different advice. Identify the pattern of your fights and effort to not be repeated. For example, like think about that. If you had a, you know, camera like this in your house, and take your fight, if it takes your fight, then you know you show it, you watch it. You know, it's amazing. Same thing happening again and again, same style. You know, you should know what's happening between us, and carefully, you shouldn't repeat it. Take a break if your discussion is taking to become a fight. 20 minutes break, because your physiology will be, you know, your stress level will decrease. It can be possible to talk. It's a very important technique. It's very simple. Take a break. Shouldn't be less than 20 minutes. Actually, my suggestion should be more than 1 hour. When you come together, please don't talk. Fighting issue. Talk is, you know, another problem, another thing. Maybe 20 hours later, return the back fight issue when you are having, you know, drinking coffee. Okay? Yes. Okay. And they do not remain cross in English, silently. You know, this is the very different, original for the Turkey. It maybe belongs to our culture. And the people have a tendency in become, you know, cross. Some people cross very easily. Some people never cross. Think about yourself or your spouse. If you become cross, you know, you are changing. You are not looking their eyes. Your distance is getting big when you are cross. You know, your speaking words is getting decreased. This is a silent treatment. Look at them, happily married wife. There must have been times we crossed. Sure, this is life, but I'm not one crossed easily. My husband has tendency to, but that is too not one of them that lasts for a long time. Another husband, married for 31 years, our cross periods last for no more than 3 or 5 hours. We both reconcile. It's very easy. What about the, you know, unhappy couples? We are sometimes cross for 2 or 3 months. When we have a married for 15 years, we become cross very frequently. Crossness is one aspect of our relationship. In fact, the main ingredient of our relationship. It's happening again and again. Advice, for advice, you know. Cross with difficulty, reconcile easily. It's like a slogan, you know. Develop a mutual reconciliation code, ritual. Never reject the step taken for reconciliation. You know, one of spouse comes to you, your wife or your husband, okay, let we say in Turkish, barışmak, reconciliation, okay? It's a big chance. Never say no. If you say no, it will get cross again, you know, and that he will not come or she will not come again. And it will last long time, okay? Put a limit on duration of remaining cross. In my workshop, we are making agreement with the husband and their wife. They are making their agreement. How, you know, how many hours they can cross me, or how their, you know, their style become a reconciled. They are right. They are making writing agreement about this, and then they are putting the refrigerator on it. Okay. And then I will be speeding. And the five quality, they protect the main their sexual routine. They are looking their sexuality a positive manner. Sexual intercourse having a stable frequency. Mutual desire during sexual interaction. For example, happily married husband, I am content of my sex life. It's among the human needs. All frequency fluctuates between twice a week. It's looking happy, you know. Happily married wife, that aspect of our life is just fine. If marriage has four stepping stones, the first is without doubt sexuality. You know, she knows what's important in marriage. Look at the unhappy marriage. A man, a divorce later, we have no sex life for the past year. Problem is our life increased and our sex life was swallowed by them too. My wife is the opinion that sex has no place in poor spousal relations. And a wife, in the midst of the marital difficulty, my husband desires sex without being verbally intimated close to me. You know, there is a bit differences between men and women. Actually, I have 10 different advice. Please, you should, you know, look positively at the sexual life. Sex has the potential of deepening or destroying your marriage. Maintain a positive outlook on sexuality. Mutual desire is important. Develop your sex life. It can be better, you know, you can learn. Men and women differ in their approach to sexuality. Okay, how about the money? When I did this research, I expecting this happy marriage people say some way how to you know manage the money. They should find some you know way, but it's surprising there is no one way. Some people said, oh, okay, husband manager, no problem for me, wife said. Some, you know, people say, okay, my wife managing money, it's not a problem, it's a guy, find money for me, or joint management. Our money is the hands of my husband. I love spending money, I don't know it's worth. Okay, another. Okay, I have a couple here, both of them doctors. Husband of the couple, both are doctors, say, my wife says that as I am the man of the house, I'm responsible for the care of the family. She's investing her own money along with her mom. I recently asked for some financial support and he rejected her. So, you know. There, this argument. If any, you know, feeling injustice or feeling being ripped off or lack of trust is all that destructive. And another problem is how to raise their kids, okay? And the housework. Okay, I should be a little speedy. Okay, this is important. They are also good friends. It's not, you know, absolute necessary. But couple also, you know, close friend is a big chance. What's that mean, become a friends? Being emotionally connected to one another, enjoying conversing with one another, enjoying spending time and doing things with one another, remaining connected with one another throughout the day. You know, this is the book, The Ring of the Dove. Have you read it?
No.
You should read it. It's a 10th century, Ibn Hazm from Andalus.
Mm.
It's a perfect book about the, you know, the man-woman relationship. It says, there are those who say too much talks endanger love. This is an opinion that must be totally belittled. Quite the contrary. The longer one is the company of the other, the longer and the deeper they bond, and is likely to be. He says, keep talking. It's better for you. Look at the happily marriage. A husband, my wife and I, we converse so much. We converse throughout the long trip, for instance, and won't even realize how the time has passed. Sometimes I'm asking a question, when you are going to, you know, a long trip, what's happening between yours? Are you talking or you are looking each other side? It's a very good sign. Okay, I can say it's not 100% sure, you know, but it's also, if you are talking, if you are, liking each other, we become, you know, make a together activity, is a very good tool for the, your marriage. For example, unhappy marriage, my husband does not call me much. I want to keep in touch, I mean there is a WhatsApp and all, but neither calls nor replies to my messages. One only rarely does. This led me to leave the habit too. Our connection has really cut off.
That's weird.
I have 5 advice. Please converse frequently. Conversing makes bonds grow stronger. Find and do activity you both enjoy. Try to find. In my workshop, I'm giving the list, different 50 activity, both of them. And please choose, sign it, which one is your good for you. And show me your spouse. And make a plan for the next, this year. Sometimes you will do, you know, step by step. Keep in touch throughout the day. If calling is difficult, at least we messaging, we have message, mails or WhatsApp. Use WhatsApp. WhatsApp is usually is bad things, but it's very good for spouses. Please send a message throughout the day. You know, tiny, small, but keeping in touch is very good things for the spouse. Go to collective events of organization together, having similar goals, passion and ideas, increase the sense of us. You know, go to together the community. You know, do good things for the people together. But develop a spiritual or higher moral goal and ideal together. Such ideals and effort achieving them deepens bonds. Example. Raising exemplary Muslim family, praying collectively at night, you know, dreaming we go to, together on heaven, like, you know, if you think together, your bond will be strong. Okay, let's finish it. 7 lessons to learn from happily married couples. One, first, number one, try to maintain a positive view on your spouse. Remind yourself of his or her positive attributes. Frequently. I'm sorry. Two, identify, accept, and manage the differences you and your spouse have been one another. Number three, do not go into destructive fights with your spouse. Four, do not cross with your spouse, and if you do, keep it short, very short. Keep your intimacy and sex life going. Number six, dive in the six main areas of challenge in married life: family relation, money, kids, housework, and the rising of the kids and free time. Mutual and supportive. You try to deal with it. And the last one, try to be good friends. Okay, thank you. I hope one day, if my mind is getting better, I will come here and one day. I think you should have a workshop as a community. Mm-hmm. Conference form is not enough. Mm-hmm. Because you need a skill. Mm-hmm. Without skill, it's not easy to become better. Mm-hmm. Okay? Thank you.
How'd you learn all this?
I'm married for 25 years. Number one, I have three kids, and I'm a couple therapist, and I'm giving a courses at the university about the relationship, and also I am doing some research. When I making this. Program, I search all of the program. I think my program different, at least to affect the other program. One of the second one, knowing each other, differences each other, and the silent treatment. It's because it's belong to our culture. Because my patients, always say we are küs in Turkey, we say silent küsmek. It's so common. People say. Kiss make. If you have a problem, it's like they have this kind of kiss make. We kiss. Even children do it. It's a medical cultural things. And I show him a client told me again and again. I said, oh, it's important. There is not this kind of things the other program, but I should put it. Because it's a real thing. It's the most important part in my workshop. People find it's very, very useful. Okay. Thank you.